SpaceX's billionaire founder and CEO, Elon Musk, outlined some ambitious goals for the company's Starship Mars colonization system. Musk answered a volley of questions over Twitter on the 16th of January, Thursday evening, providing more details about SpaceX Starship and how it will eventually need to work in order to achieve Musk's goals of making humans an interplanetary species with a colony on Mars. The SpaceX Starship architecture consists of a big spaceship called Starship, which Musk has said will be capable of carrying up to 100 people, and a giant rocket named Super Heavy. Both of these vehicles will be reusable. Indeed, rapid and frequent reuse is key to Musk's overall vision, which involves cutting the cost of spaceflight enough to make Mars colonization and other bold exploration feats economically feasible. He's discussed some of this before, but Musk reiterated that SpaceX Starship will need to operate on a brisk schedule, ferrying many megatons per year of cargo to the Red Planet in order to establish and maintain a human presence there. In this video, Engineering Today will discuss Elon Musk's ambitious goals for the company's Starship Mars colonization system, where Elon Musk gives details about sending 1 million people to Mars by 2050. Let's get started. In one of Thursday's tweets, for example, Musk wrote that the eventual goal is to launch each SpaceX Starship vehicle 3 times per day on average. Each SpaceX Starship will be able to carry about 100 tons of payload to orbit, so at that flight rate, a total of more than 1,000 flights per year per vehicle. Musk didn't specify what exactly the rockets would need to carry to Mars, but lots of food, water, building materials, tools, and advanced life support systems are a given. Thus, he estimated he'll need a whole fleet of Starships to build a permanent settlement. Megatons per year to orbit are needed for life to become multiplanetary, he tweeted on Thursday. In total, 1,000 SpaceX Starships could hypothetically transport about 100 megatons of stuff to Mars. That's the volume Musk has said he hopes to send to the Red Planet. Ultimately, Musk says that he hopes to achieve a construction rate of 100 SpaceX Starships being produced per year, with a goal of hitting 1,000 in total in service over the course of the next decade, which can transport as much as 100 megatons per year in cargo, or about 100,000 people per Earth-Mars orbital sync in terms of human passengers. Building 100 Starships per year gets to 1,000 in 10 years, or 100 megatons per year, or maybe around 100,000 people per Earth-Mars orbital sync, Musk wrote in another Thursday tweet. Orbital sync refers to an alignment of the two planets that's favorable for interplanetary travel, which comes along just once every 26 months, when Earth and Mars are closest to one another because of the coincidence of their respective orbits around the Sun. Musk clarified in response to another question that the way this will work will be getting the Mars fleet into a staging orbit above Earth, where they can be refueled in space prior to their synchronized departure. Then, once every 26 months, approximately 1,000 ships will depart over the course of 30 days for their Mars transit. While SpaceX Starship will require an in-orbit refuel to make the trip to Mars leaving from Earth because of how much boost is needed to exit Earth's atmosphere. The same is not true for the reverse trip, Musk pointed out. Super Heavy won't make trips to Mars, by the way. The huge rocket is needed just to get the Starship vehicle off Earth. The passenger spacecraft will be able to launch itself off the Moon and Mars, both of which are much smaller than our planet and therefore much easier to escape. Musk envisions huge fleets of SpaceX Starships departing during these Earth-Mars orbital sync windows. Loading the Mars fleet into Earth orbit, then 1,000 ships depart over approximately 30 days every 26 months, Battlestar Galactica, he wrote in another tweet. Musk wants all of this activity to lead to the establishment of a sustainable settlement on the Red Planet. This goal, making humanity a multi-planet species, is close to the entrepreneur's heart. He's repeatedly stressed that it's why he founded SpaceX back in 2002, and why he's been amassing wealth for the past few decades. Back in mid-2017, Musk said that SpaceX Starship architecture, which was then called the Interplanetary Transport System, could potentially allow a million-person city to rise on Mars. SpaceX's goal, according to Musk, is to ultimately send 1 million people to Mars by 2050, something Musk also confirmed in another reply to a Twitter user. The goal is to make it common enough and affordable enough that anyone can go if they want. Musk has floated $500,000 per seat with a guaranteed return ticket if you change your mind. But this is the first time he suggested the idea of loans for people who couldn't afford it. Don't worry though, he also says there will be plenty of jobs on Mars, although it's not clear what would happen if you didn't repay the loan. Do they waste fuel hauling you back to Earth? As Musk has emphasized at every step of SpaceX's development, reusability in the Starship system is key. Musk wants each Starship to keep flying for a while. In yet another tweet, he said SpaceX is aiming for an operational life of 20 to 30 years for each vehicle, similar to commercial aircraft today, he noted. That's required if the company hopes to be able to operate at the scale described, while doing so in a way that's anywhere near economically viable. He's still working toward an ambitious timeline, an even more ambitious one, in fact. SpaceX Starship is currently in development with a new prototype under construction at its Texas facility. The company already built a subscale demonstrator without a nose cone to test the new engines it's worked on for the Starship, and demonstrated those working successfully for controlled low-altitude flight. It built a large prototype that it originally said would be used for high-altitude testing, but that one failed during an early pressure test and now has moved on to a third version with a refined and improved design, which the company says will be used for orbital flight testing this year. Elon Musk appears to be pretty focused on SpaceX Starship right now, sharing photos of the work being done on the orbital Starship prototype, designated SN1, which is currently under construction at SpaceX's Boca Chica, Texas facility. Musk tweeted a photo of technicians working on the SN1's nose cone and liquid oxygen header tank. Musk has said a new version of SpaceX Starship prototype may launch before the end of March. First flight is hopefully 2 to 3 months away, Musk tweeted on December 27th. The company could build as many as 20 different prototypes before engineers settle on a 1.0 design to fly cargo and people. The full SpaceX launch system would also include a 22-story rocket booster Super Heavy. Combined, the whole thing would stand about 387 feet, or 118 meters tall. During launch, a Starship spaceship would ride atop the booster, then disconnect after the booster runs low on fuel and rocket its way into orbit. Musk said in September that he hopes to launch a SpaceX Starship into orbit by mid-2020, and maybe even fly a person in it before the end of the year. Gwynne Shotwell, the president and chief operating officer of SpaceX, said during a NASA teleconference that the company is aiming to be able to drop Starship on the lunar surface in 2022 and fly Japanese tech entrepreneur and billionaire Yusaku Maezawa around the moon in 2023. Currently, Yusaku Maezawa is looking for a life partner to accompany him on a trip to the moon as SpaceX's first private tourist passenger. Maezawa said he was restarting his life, having acquired his fortune as founder of Japan's largest fashion retail website, ZOZOTOWN. Maezawa tweeted a link to a website on the 12th of January, Sunday, advertising his serious matchmaking documentary called Full Moon Lovers, where women could apply to join him on a voyage around the moon on SpaceX Starship rocket in 2023. However, all of those timelines came before the SpaceX Starship prototype explosion. SpaceX will also have to clear several regulatory and practical hurdles, including securing the safety of residents of Boca Chica Village, which sits within 2 miles of SpaceX's Texas launch pad, before it can launch any prototypes to orbit. Helping to pay for this is why I'm accumulating assets on Earth, Musk tweeted on Thursday. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.